Good evening. Good evening. Good evening. How are you?
Quando riguarda e sto sforzando utenti di varsa e sto e quanto è bello e vai red hey
the hell were you? Did you get caught in traffic? Yeah. Well, we don't want you to feel that you have missed... We don't want you to feel that you've missed everything at all. See, what happened was, Zubin was standing out... We did La Gazzolata. Okay? And we came to the end, and it went something like this. Where's my stick? Here, no. Just talk among yourselves for a minute while I find my book. Latecomers applaud. Meine Damen und Herren, ladies and gentlemen, this is the centennial von Grödenwölz, and we would like the honor of doing this next piece dedicated to the other man, which also was not here. This is a piece from Strauss, written in 19, for here already. You didn't even wait very long to leave. Why didn't you go before you came in? This is a piece from Strauss, written in 1947. No, this was Max Strauss from Pittsburgh, and he wrote this piece, which is a lullaby, and it is called Das kleine Würdenheer. Gentle, delicate little lullaby. Das kleine Werden her, haben Sie aber gehüten das Fröschen gehören. Aber das Knall haben sie gefunden, das aus mit der Knall wieder Helden. Und das Abend gezeigt mit der aus mit der Knall wieder Helden. Und dann lausen sie den Polka, was everybody is playing. It's a delicate little lullaby. You. And right this minute, I'm having the best time I've had in years. Are you all familiar with the Tchaikovsky Nutcracker Suite? Huh? Yeah. Well, we're not going to do it. No, we're going to do it if you really want to hear it, because that's very sad. Well, I don't know. Fellas, ladies, do you remember the Nutcracker Suite? You remember it? Yeah, well, we'll have to kind of fake it a little bit here, but okay. Don't let them see you turning the pages. Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky, born in Brooklyn, emigrated to Montana, because there was no way he would get anywhere with a name like Tchaikovsky, and the people didn't. So he went, took a name of Brazov, and became a movie writer. Right? That
That's all. Now hold it. Now.
Middle of a movement. That man tried to applaud. Did you see what happened to him? He had to leave. No, but I think he had an accident. Okay, you can applaud as much as you like. Have a good time. Yeah. If you're going to do it, then do it right. I mean, don't perform perfectly. Perfunctorily. I mean, if you're going to do it, let's hear it. That's the part I love in that whole thing. A marvelous sound. Listen. Here, you'd all do it with me. Look. Bop, 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 when I give you the cue. And. That's pathetic. Let me hear from this azle over to the left. All the way up and down. Let me hear. Bop, 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 when I give you the beat. And. Let me hear this group.
A 1.5 from the high ball.
This I you sing, ma. Everybody with me up and down and hold it real loud. We go, ma. You sing, ma. Ma. Dearly beloved. This is the one I am crazy about. It absolutely destroyed me. All right, here we go. And very quiet. My fault. Serious piece.
Thank you.
No. You see, they are so stunned by the way you played this so beautifully. They are all choked up. They couldn't even make a sound. Wasn't that beautiful the way they did that? Piece of music, isn't it? It's light and it's gay and it's joyful. Well, I must explain. Anybody who stands on this podium reflects their innermost secrets. They reflect their strengths, their weaknesses, their neuroticisms, all the component parts that go into making it a human being. It is the greatest feeling of neurotic power in the world. It's really true. Want to see? Who's a conductor, and he just had a baby. Everything reflects itself in your everyday work, your emotional state. He has a baby, and he goes around pushing the baby carriage. He's crazy about it. And when he conducts, it winds up the same way. Here we go. Doesn't like to lose contact with his audience. Emotional conductor, no matter what he plays, it tears from him out his whole Gulwald. Conductor, who is slightly neurotic, and everything he does affects him in a particular way. When he gets nervous, he develops an allergy. Should have retired 100 years ago. Thank you.
want to rest a little bit?
All right.
Yes, I'll be serving this rice to the hoodie, mate. I'm feeling young, plim plum, you're the only one. I remember we're going to get this. Don't forget that. And we make a small...
What the hell are you laughing at here?
You've been coming to concerts for years? Yeah. Well, I tell you, I have too. And for all those years, I'm sure, you have seen nothing but the back of a conductor. Now, you must wonder how he communicates with the players, what kind of a rapport he has. What kind of an O'Leary he has, all right? And we will do the triumphal march of Aida, except I will face you, and you will see exactly what goes on in the face of a conductor. Thank you. While you are on your feet, the ladies can pull their dresses away from them, and we can have a little intermission. Don't wander in. We got a lot to do, so hurry back to your seats. Hurry up.
We'll see you in a moment.
Things with the long tails. But this is much more comfortable to work in. What? All right. Like my shoes, huh? Okay. Would you do me a favor, honey? All right, stand up for 1 minute and take one shoe off. Yeah, just one shoe off. That's it. Oh, she's got a big buckle. Once you quit, all right, now put it on the floor. Put it on the floor and stand next to it. Stand next to your shoe, dear. Okay, do you have good eyes? How do you get all of that foot into that tiny little shoe? You know, driving me crazy. Women used to have a kind of a grace. They used to walk, and it was a flowing kind of thing, and then platform shoes came. Platform shoes came in, and now women all walk like they just came from a severe gynecological examination. Ladies and gentlemen, to all the men and women who use electric razors. Gentlemen, some people have greater longevity than others. We are going to do a piece by the greatest longev of all time, a fellow called Beethoven. Horace Emanuel Beethoven. Now, the reason he lived so long, because he was the longest finisher on record. Now, we have been doing a thing with Beethoven for years, and we have never finished together yet. Tonight, September 23rd, at the Avery Fisher Hall in Lincoln Center, may be the magical moment. In Tanglewood, they have a shed, and a great many people... Boston? Oh, do you sit in the back part of the shed? Because if you're over 40, then you have to sit in the short part of the shed. And you have to wear a sports shirt. It is really a lovely place. And I was there a couple of summers ago. And it was a rather cool afternoon. And people were sitting in the shed, and they spilled over onto the grass. And in the Berkshires, the smell of new-mown grass and the trees gently waving in the very, very soft breezes was an absolute delight. and the damn flies were eating you up. We will do now the flight of the bumblebee by those two very British composers, Rimsky and Korsakov. The flight of the bumblebee. I have here a fella who is a crying laugher. Right in the orchestra. When everybody stops laughing, he goes, hey! In Portland, a week ago Saturday, we did a concert, and there was a machine gun laugher. Right in the middle of everything, he went, ah! People were ducking under the seats and everything. But the one I'm really crazy about is the backdrafter. The backdrafter, nothing comes out on the way forward. They kill themselves. They go, I once sat in front of a woman like that, sucked my whole scarf in. They just played an 11. This is an 11. Ah-di-dang, ah-di-dang, ah-da-di-yo, ah-di-dang, go-ke-do, no-mo-kanda, na-ril-bo-di-go-ka-shi-ni-moon, shi-him-ni-do-mo-ka-su-pa-ri-pi. That's a Korean folk song. Dozo. Dozo. Now, I guarantee you, they knew nothing about this at all. They'd never had any idea they were going to stand up or sing a song or anything. And she's not very nervous at all. Shō-shō-shō-jōji, nō-ni-wa-wa. Well, you're singing like a baritone. Is it too high? Shō-shō-shō-jōji, shō-jōji. What key do you want to sing it in? Shō.
Shō.
Do, do. Shō, 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 jō, jī, shō, jō, jī, no, ni, wa, wa. Tsun, 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 ki, o, da, mi, na, de, te, koi, koi, koi. O, I, ra, no, to, mu, do, chō, bom, bom, bom. Gilbert, anytime you need them to do a bass roll, she can sing it for you. Right? In many, many years ago, in a conflagration that tore a European state apart many, many years ago, there was a young man incarcerated in jail. Now, whether he was a political prisoner, a social prisoner, or he might have just been a thief, I don't know. Anyway, he was not released from that jail for years. And in order to maintain his sanity, with his fingernails, he scratched music on the wall. Some 112 years later, when they redid this whole town and dug it up, they found this plaque. And they could tell it was a fingernail. And tonight, here with the New York Philharmonic, we want to do the 11th movement of a symphony called what? It is virtually impossible for me to continue unless there's a deathly hush in the auditorium.
Sometimes stand like this for 3 days. Would you like to hear that again? Well, why don't you say that on Thursday night? Thank you.
do serious stuff, huh? Down here, that line. Swing. All right, now, diaphragma, Mosca. Swing low and. Not you, that's that aisle over there. I'll give you a part. Sweet chariot, sweet chariot, sweet chariot, sweet chariot. Swing low. All right, now you start. Swing low, sweet chariot, sweet chariot. La. That's beautiful. I think when he's telling me afterwards won't be so pleasant. Oh, I have a thing. You know, everybody thinks of Beethoven, Tchaikovsky, Mahler as having very difficult passages for all the instrumentalists. Now, there's a light, supposedly, I don't know what semi-classical means, but there's supposedly a light piece of music that is as difficult to play as anything you'll find in the classics. It's called Fiddle Faddle. We are going to play it at a tempo that is virtually impossible to play. And you will hear one of the greatest virtuoso orchestras you have ever heard in your life. Your New York Philharmonic. something, and I didn't, certainly wouldn't want you. Aldo, how are you? Would you all like to stand up for 1 second? No, just go ahead. Just stand up and kind of, you know, do that. Come on. Father, stand up, will you? So then they'll be able... Come on. It's the only red-headed Italian in New York City. All right. Yum, ta-da-ga-dum, pam, pam. Listen to the trumpet. Towns any of you come from, but years ago in all towns they used to have a mall, and they would have Sunday afternoon concerts, and it was usually a brass band that used to play. And in the brass band they usually had a choir of 4 trumpets and a soloist who was called the silver-tongued trumpeter. Now there's a man called Del Steger, I believe, who is phenomenal, and we have a thing that I would like to do with the choir of the brass here. If you will give me a key. Oh, you have to raise your stand, that's it. Stand up. Is that the key? Ba-bim. The soloist would sing, would play. Ba-da-da-da-da-da-da. Lam-bam-ba-da-da-da-da. La-la-da-da-da-da-da-da. La 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 da da. And then the choir would play. Then they used to get to the difficult part, which was called triple tongue, and they would play. Dum tarak 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 tarak. Germans march on, and they have the same mall and the same trumpeters, but now they do a modern version of the Carnival of Venice. There, that's comfortable. I'm delighted you're all here tonight. I don't know whether you know this. I suppose you have read about it somewhere. I don't know how to read music. But if you're anything like I am, oh, God, you better hope you're not, because you'd all be in a loony bin by now. I just wanted to tell you that you have done the nicest thing tonight that anybody could do. You have come here tonight, and you have held out a hand in friendship and in love, and you have made it possible for all of these players, all of these musicians, all of these human beings who have devoted their lives and their energies and their love into making music for you, to bringing you joy and bringing you happiness. When the time comes for them to put down their instruments, you tonight have made it possible for them to live in some kind of comparative security. And I tell you, if more people would embrace each other and do what you are doing tonight, it would be a sweet and generous and wonderful and loving world that we would live in. Now, no, I have to do that. They really do a remarkable job, as do all of symphony orchestras throughout the nation. And by virtue of what you have done, when you go home tonight and you put your head on your pillow, you can smile and say, I did something nice for somebody. And you'll get up refreshed and warm and invigorated. And you have done something very, very nice by coming here tonight. Now, because we live in a crazy, miraculous, loving country, many people have come here. And when the arms of the United States were open to people from many, many different nations, many different nationalities, many different ethnic groups, many different religious groups, they all gravitated here. because there was basic freedom. And in this orchestra itself are people from faraway lands who have banded together in harmony to bring you music. There's one piece of music, I think, that reflects the spirit of the United States more than any other. And we'd like to play it for you now.
Thank you very much.
don't know when I've had a better, more exhilarating, and more delightful time in my life. This orchestra is superb. They really are. My orchestra in Los Angeles is a pretty good band, too. They are all superb, and I tell you something, Zubin, you're really a remarkable fellow. You really are. And the kind of music you make with this orchestra is incredible. When you leave, one word of admonition. When you drive home, drive on the sidewalks. All the accidents are happening in the street. Good night, good luck, and God bless you.